If you want to watch some of our episodes online, it's very simple. YouTube, our handle is at Urban TV Uganda, hashtag Campus 101. On Facebook, use the hashtag Campus 101. We have everything that you know we've been sharing for the couple of weeks down the road. And if you want to watch all that, it's already online. For the meantime, let's check out some of the biggest stories we have for you this weekend. Today in Campus Juice, Cavendish University announced exciting news of receiving the accreditation nod from National Council for Higher Education for its open distance and e-learning program approved by the government. We spoke to Mr. Fred Mufta on phone, the head of marketing, for more details about it.
Thank you, Kashmir and Urban TV, for giving Cavendish University this opportunity to express itself over the recent National Council of Higher Education approval to CUU to conduct open distance and e-learning. Of course, like any institution currently suffering the negative effects of COVID-19 on education, we at Cavendish University Uganda are both excited and grateful that we are now able to progress with our teaching and learning. Being one of the only two universities in Uganda that are currently approved talks to our innovativeness and preparedness to teach online using our highly interactive and resource-based platform. We are with immediate effect resuming our classes to complete semester one by the 28th of August 2020 and also embark on our semester two that will begin on the 21st of September 2020.
In other news, Kampala International University inaugurated a new chancellor, Professor Mahmoud Mamdan, a leading Ugandan academician, author, and political commentator. Professor Mahmoud Mamdan is also the director of the Makerere University Institute of Social Research and has replaced Professor JMP Sewufu, who successfully completed his term of office as Chancellor KIU. This inauguration ceremony took place virtually and was attended by many. Just to let you know where I'm catching the show from this weekend, I'm at KIU, Kampala International University. Gone are the days when, you know, this entire place where I'm standing used to be full of students coming in and going out. But because of the COVID-19 pandemic, I'm literally doing this show alone in this big compound. Anyway, let's shoot to Gulu University. And of course, in Wall of Fame, we'll bring you some of the guild aspirants. And today we have a female guild aspirant from Gulu University.
My name is Dolphine Alonyo. I'm pursuing a Bachelor's of Laws at Gulu University. I'm in my third year. If not for COVID-19, I would definitely be in my fourth and final year. I am also contesting for Gulu University Guild President 2020-2021. We were interrupted so suddenly by the pandemic, by the COVID-19 pandemic. The main roles and duties of a guild president is to link the students' fraternity with the administrative fraternity of the university. A guild president must give firm representation in Senate, in management, in council, in the legislative arm of government and the executive arm of government. A guild president is that aspect of change, is the role model, the face of the university, one that represents the voice of all students. A guild president stands firm for every student, for who they are. A guild president has the sole duty to create opportunities, conditions that are favorable for students to bring out the innovation and the creativity in them. The guild president, through his government, have the mandate to link students with opportunities in the university, outside the university, even outside our country, Uganda, to the wider ranges of countries out there. I am contesting for guild presidency. I want to be the positive voice that stands for the students, a voice that speaks for a student regardless of his tribe, his political affiliation, his religious belonging, his regional his regional backgrounds, a voice that speaks for students because they are simply students, and they are students that deserve services because they paid for these services, a voice that stands firm and provides and fights and acknowledges that we as students deserve change, that we as students deserve better welfare, we as students deserve the best of education when it comes to the education sector, that we want to go out there as finalists and get opportunities, job opportunities out there, a voice that cares that a student must be in position to regain his transcript early in time, a voice that looks at our welfare. Whether you're a student with a special need, you need to have equal welfare. A voice that looks at our security, a voice that looks at every aspect of anything that affects students while in the university. I want to be that aspect of change. I want to be that aspect of voice. A voice that does not discriminate you because you are born woman or man, because for as long as a woman has the same opportunities, for as long as the woman has the same knowledge, the same wisdom, the same experience, then surely a woman must be given an opportunity as well. I stand to be that voice for the students of Gulu University.
It's been a beautiful show, and I thank William on the camera, my editor Paul, Team Campus 101, the ambassadors, and to all the fans that watch this show each and every Saturday midday, and I repeat on Thursday 2 p.m. And don't forget, I am styled by Vasiguru in Kansanga, because we love campus, and we are Campus 101. My name is MC Casmill. Yeah, yeah.